Yes, you've caught me watching RuPaul's Drag Race on VH1. I wasn't going to do a video tonight, but April Derleth passed away yesterday, and it made me really sad. April, of course, is the daughter of August Derleth, and August Derleth, with Donald Wandre, created Arkham House for the sole purpose of publishing the fiction of H.P. Lovecraft in hardcover editions. This is the second book they published of Lovecraft's work, Beyond the Wall of Sleep. This was sent to me by my friend Carlos. Carlos, if you're watching, I love this book. It has so much of what I love in H.P. Lovecraft. It has my very favorite work, The Case of Charles Dexter Ward. It has a bunch of poems near the back, I think. Poems are. This is a great book, and Arkham House was a publishing house created by Donald Wandre and August Derleth. And Wandre became active in military service, and Derleth pretty much ran Arkham House on his own. He was the chief operator. It was his decision of what books they would publish. After they published Lovecraft, they began to publish Clark Ashton Smith. They published the first book by Ray Bradbury, the first book by Robert Bloch, the first book by Ramsey Campbell and Brian Lumley. My friend Carlo, who I just mentioned, he also sent me this book, which I believe this was the second book published by Arkham House, Someone in the Dark, Short Stories by August Derleth. I've been doing a series of vlogs on the posthumous collaborations stories that were written by August Derleth, and then he added Lovecraft's name to them, and it still is not clear to me why he did this. It is my theory that he was trying to write stories in the narrative voice and the fictive tradition of H.P. Lovecraft. He was trying to write stories that were Lovecraftian to the core and in Lovecraft's prose style. And it is my opinion that he failed to do this, except in some few stories, the finest of which, I believe, is The Survivor. Just a magnificent story. But it was August Derleth who brought Lovecraft into the limelight, and no one can deny that. We may have our opinions about how Derleth went about this. Some people paint him as a bully, trying to own Lovecraft and not letting anyone else publish Lovecraft unless they had Derleth's permission and the permission of Arkham House, when actually he really did not have the legal permission. It's all very convoluted. But facts are facts. It was August Derleth, H.P. Lovecraft's friend and admirer, who published Lovecraft's first books, and who devoted himself to helping Lovecraft become a world-renowned author of weird fiction. Derleth did it. No one else did it. And for that, we owe Derleth a profound debt of gratitude. I believe this is the first book published in America of the fiction of William Hope Hodgson. Derleth did all these things. He published books that no one else would touch, perhaps, such as the poems and prose by Clark Ashton Smith. This is a magnificent book. He published the wonderful poetry of Donald Wandre, Poems for Midnight. He published anthologies of poetry. And here is a photo of Derleth and his children. That's Walden, and that's April. April, who passed away yesterday at the very young age of, I think she was 54 or 56 years of age. Way too young. Arkham House, of course, also published really great collections by August Derleth. And he was an extremely fine writer of ghost stories, and his stories had a very simple charm. As an editor, he brought us wonderful anthologies. This is one of his finest, Dark Things. He did this all through Arkham House. The anthology that is really significant for me is the original edition of Tales of the Cthulhu Mythos. And it was reading this book that made me want to become a writer. Tales of the Cthulhu Mythos by H.P. Lovecraft and others, collected by August Derleth, published by Arkham House. It was reading this book that filled me with this intense ache to join the club, to become a modern member of the Lovecraft Circle, to write stories in the tradition of the Cthulhu Mythos, a tradition that originated with Lovecraft but was named and hugely created by August Derleth. And as with everything Derleth did, there's controversy about the mythos, what it is, should it have been created, should it be associated with H.P. Lovecraft, etc., etc. Of course, Lovecraft, Derleth's very controversial posthumous collaborations have upset a lot of people who feel that he was using Lovecraft's name to sell his own books, but we must remember that at the time these stories and books were first published by Arkham House and August Derleth, Lovecraft had no world reputation. Derleth was not getting rich by using Lovecraft's name because people had never heard of H.P. Lovecraft. It was because of August Derleth that Lovecraft became a world-famous writer and had his books published internationally. Derleth loved the art of pastiche, and one of his finest creations as a pastiche artist is Solar Pons, which is his version of Sherlock Holmes. I've got the paperback sets, and they are quite... I find these stories charming. It's because of Derleth and his creation of Arkham House. When I first began to buy Arkham House books, they had an aura about them that no other publisher has been able to match. There is a magic about Arkham House books. And I can't really quite explain it, but they have a kind of mystique. And it became my hot desire to have a story published in an Arkham House anthology. And I was recently invited by the delightful Lois Gresh, who I met at MythosCon in January. And she is working on a new anthology of weird fiction for Arkham House, to be called Arkham Nightmares, and she invited me to write. I've been having trouble writing the story. And, but just the idea that I could possibly have a story published in an Arkham House anthology, it's still, just the idea of it makes my eyes shimmer with excitement. It's such a wonderful dream. Perhaps it will be a dream come true. We don't know now what is going to happen with Arkham House. Hopefully things will be put on pause. In a statement that was published on the Locus magazine website, it says that the orders for new orders for books, and I believe productions of books, will be suspended momentarily. We really hope that this is not the end of Arkham House. But obviously things are going to have to be worked out for it to continue as a publishing house. A while back, Hippocampus Press published in two beautiful volumes the correspondence of H.P. Lovecraft and August Derleth. H.P. Lovecraft admired Derleth intensely as an author. And Derleth did so many things. And he inspired a lot of people through his writing and through his publishing to write. And it is hugely because of August Derleth that I am the author of The Tangled Muse. And happily, in this book, I have a story called The Imp of Aether. Can't find my glasses, so I won't be able to find it. But it is a story that I dedicated to page 79. Let me see if I can find it. It's a story that I dedicated to August Derleth, to his memory. Here we are. The Imp of Aether. Dedicated to August William Derleth. Derleth was a sister. He was an out and open bisexual at a time in America when it took courage to be so. So, rest in peace, April Derleth. We shall miss you. Shalom.